The game starts not when beginning a new game, but before we even hit the main menu. Yeah, it's one of those games. To be fair, the cutscene here is quite amazing for its time, and yeah, I know I sound like a broken record for basically repeating that phrase over and over and over again during this marathon, but seriously, put yourself in the shoes of somebody playing this game back in 98. We did not get cinematics like this very often in video games. Anyways, the plot of this game is that aliens have taken over a space station in the future and are now going through time to eliminate the human race. Yeah, this is one of those don't think too hard about the plot type of games. It's a decent setup for a fun sci-fi adventure, and thankfully it never tries to be more than that. Now for the gameplay. It's essentially a third-person shooter, and the auto-aim works pretty well when you're on foot. When you're in a vehicle, not as well, but it still gets the job done. I will admit that moving around can feel a bit stiff, but it's far from the worst I've played. We'll be getting to that eventually, trust me. I should note that this game was developed by DMA Design, who would later go on to make the Grand Theft Auto games. So in a way, this is GTA before GTA. Although there is another N64 game they made with a similar mechanic. We'll have to save that for a later date, unfortunately. Back to the gameplay. You'll be given missions frequently via this chick who looks like she jumped out of an anime from the 80s. By the way, if any anime studios are watching this, then I will totally be down for a body harvest anime. Oh, and when I say you'll be given missions frequently, I fucking mean it. After playing this, nobody, and I mean nobody, has any right to bitch about Navi or Fi ever again. The biggest downfall of this game is its save feature. I know you all heard others bitch about games just let you save whenever you want, now checkpoints are bullshit, and you may be tired of hearing about it, but if you want a game that shows exactly why save points are BS, then here you go. In Body Harvest, the only way to save is after a boss fight. That means until you clear out at least one boss, you can't save. And this isn't one of those games that just hand you the first boss on a silver platter. No, that would be merciful, and DMA is all out of that. It's because of this that the game can become pretty rage-inducing if you were to die either at a boss fight, or hell, any time, as when you die, you get booted back to the main menu, and you have to start over from the last time you saved. The biggest saving grace for me is the music. God damn, is it amazing. Seriously, just listen to some of these tracks. This game's music was composed by Stuart Ross and Alan Walker. You two gentlemen deserve all the praise for this game's soundtrack alone. I also like the portraits of the people when you talk to them. I feel like this is really a 90s thing, and you don't see this type of stuff anymore unless it's in an RPG, which is really a shame. So congrats to you, Stacy Jameson.
Final thoughts on Body Harvest. While far from a terrible game, at the same time it's far, far, oh so far from a great game. So I can only give this a half recommendation. I mean, if you liked what you saw in the video, you go ahead and just pick this one right up. But just know what you're getting yourself into. It's not going to be the best of times, but it's also not going to be the worst of times. And until next time, this is TWK of TWK Reviews telling you to work your gimmick! For some reason, my shirt's the same color as the wall. I have no idea why.